It's a dog's life. Roland Burke reports on Japan's growing doggy obsession and explores the demographic time bomb behind it.
In a smart and expensive neighbourhood of Tokyo, Toshiko Horikoshi relaxes by playing her grand piano. She's a successful eye surgeon with her own private clinic, a stylish apartment, a Porsche in the garage, and two pet pooches.
So I have two dogs. One is Tinkerbell. She is Chihuahua. And another one is Ginger. He's teacup poodle. It's a very small, tiny dog. Japanese dog owner think dog is like a child. I have no child. I love two dogs.
Toshiko is not alone in choosing dogs instead of children. Kids are now vastly outnumbered by pets. In this BBC World Service programme, I'll be examining how Japan's dogs became the world's most pampered and the human demographic time bomb that lies behind it, a collapsing birth rate and a dramatically ageing society.
This is for Tinkerbell, a pink and black sweater. And this is a hat called Ginger. They have their own closet and a lot of clothes for summer season and for winter season.
This canine couture doesn't come cheap. A poodle pullover can cost $250 or more.
It's so expensive, I think. But I almost every weekend go to the shop to get clothes.
In the neighbourhood of Tokyo where I live, it's easier to outfit a dog than my kids. There are no children's clothes shops locally, but any number of boutiques selling clothes, sunglasses and jewellery, all for dogs.
This one's got quite a nice selection. There are school uniforms, tartan skirts and pink cardigans with a little school logo over here. What's this? It's more a kind of combat themed khaki cotton dress. There's a Mac down here, sort of shiny black with a hood. The logo on the back is super sexy. And dogs around here actually really are wearing this stuff. And they're also selling buggies, like baby buggies, but these ones are designed for dogs.
Official estimates put Japan's pet population at 22 million or more, but there are now only 16.6 million children under 15. The number of dogs has risen alongside an increase in childlessness. Many women and couples dote on their dogs and grant them all kinds of anthropomorphic privileges.
What's really interesting about this is that every single dog is some kind of pedigree. There's Dachshunds, French Bulldogs, Chihuahuas as well. And the most popular breeds, of course, are really small, tiny dogs, like lap dogs, because here in Tokyo, people live in minute apartments. It'd be a bit of a challenge to have a Great Dane. And these dogs, of course, represent a pretty big financial commitment. When you go to the pet shops, they start at about 120,000 yen, which is more than $1,000, and they go up to 400,000 yen if you buy them direct from a breeder. That's $5,000 for just one puppy. And looking around here, many people have got more than one. Two, three, there's some people with whole packs of small, well-dressed dogs.
At Aoyama Kennel, a King Charles Spaniel is having a cut and blow dry. Business is booming, says Rie Shimozono.
I think
these 10 years, people started to keep more dogs at home.
The pet industry, worth more than ₱1 trillion a year, $10 billion, has expanded into gourmet dog food stores, hot spring resorts, yoga classes, and restaurants where dogs sit on chairs to eat specially prepared organic meals.
This is handmade sweets for dogs.
Handmade sweets for dogs?
We put no chemicals in it and nice flavor. Dogs love this. The owners and dog can share the same food.
So tell me about your dogs. What kind of dogs are they?
Toy poodle no Hanamichi, 6歳 desu.
Hanamichi toy poodle and Pomeranian, and I dress them because they look cute.
Kawaii kara desu.
And do you always push them in this buggy like babies?
そうですね、子供です。
Yes, they are like our baby. We sleep together, eat together, and whenever we go, we take them. So they are just like a real child.
So this is a photo session for dogs. That clapping is people trying to draw the attention of the dog to the camera so it's looking the right direction. The dogs are dressed up, of course. But the dogs are better groomed and dressed than my kids.
Than myself, yes.
And me, yes.
Chie Kobayashi has come along to translate.
I've got to say, as a foreigner, it kind of looks a bit strange to me. What is it, do you think, about Japanese dog owners that they want to make such a fuss over their dogs?
The dog owners here just love dogs, just like their children.
So those dog biscuits obviously went down well. This dog is called Kotaro, and his owner is Jiro Akiba.
He's a miniature dachshund, really, really tiny, tiny dog. Kotaro means first little boy. He's kind of the first baby, you know, for us. And my name is Jiro. Jiro means second boy.
Why did you decide to name your dog in that way?
Because he's like my child.
You haven't got children?
We don't. It's really good things to having dog if you don't have baby, because, you know, it's quite fun to take care of him like a baby.
Was that a deliberate choice, to have a dog instead of a baby?
To be honest with you, I really want to have baby, but my partner, she doesn't want to have baby because she wants to keep her job. And Japanese society, it's really hard for the female to having baby and keep job. So that's why my girlfriend, she decided to not having baby. So that's why we have dog. I think it kind of makes sense to having dog or pets instead of even having baby, because, you know, educational fee is expensive and house is expensive, tax, and our salary, it hasn't changed for a long time.
The average fertility rate is now 1.39 children per woman, well below the number needed to keep the human population stable. Kunio Kitamura is the director of Japan's Family Planning Research Center.
The most important reason of declining birth rate is less sex.
Dr. Kitamura's surveys indicate that the nation's libido has been steadily lagging in the last decade.
48% married couples, no sexual intercourse over 1 month.
So it's no sex, please, we're Japanese. And why?
The reasons is they're tired and bored.
Married couples, perhaps sexlessness is not totally unusual in other countries as well. But what about young people in Japan?
Yes. Young people dislike sexual intercourse. Latest data, 2010, 32% dislike sexual intercourse.
So nearly a third of young people. Yeah,
that is a male's data.
A third of young men?
Yes, that's young surprising. Men. I was very surprised at that. Yeah, when I was young, my sexual desire had increased. So I tried to masturbate every night. But they dislike sexual intercourse.
Why?
They were afraid of failure of the examinations. They are afraid women may reject them.
Certainly there's been national agonizing about the current generation of young men. Do they somehow lack get up and go? They've been cruelly dismissed as herbivorous and grass-eating, and women are shunning marriage. 60% of women in their mid to late 20s are unwed. 7 out of 10 unmarried women don't even have a boyfriend. And in Japan, marriage is still, more or less, a prerequisite for having children. Only 2% are born outside wedlock.
Can you tell me what your dog is wearing? So sunglasses, a white hoodie, and a pair of jeans and shoes. Why do you dress up your dog?
I want him to look kind of strong and tough, so I put him some sunglasses on.
Does that look impress the other dogs? Do you think they think there's a cool, tough dog?
His appearance really as a very tough dog, but when actually they have the real contact, usually he loses.
So he's all trousers and no action?
Sort of.
What about from your personal point of view? Does this dog help with the ladies, having a dressed-up dog like this?
I wish I could meet somebody like that.
When I was a college student, I was very interested in having cars. Why? to make love, you know?
not driving?
Yeah.
Making love?
Make love.
Dr. Kitamura says times have really changed for the young people he interviews for his family planning research.
They have not much money. No car, no drink, no smoke.
And no sex either.
Of course, that is an economical problem in your country.
Economic stagnation has hit young men particularly hard. More than 10 million people between 20 and 34 still live with their parents. They can't afford to get married or to start a family themselves. But for the odd luxury, mobile phones, foreign travel, a treat for the dog, they can and do splash out. So this is an onsen, a Japanese hot spring for dogs. So there's a lady, member of staff in a wetsuit. She's throwing a plastic toy crocodile and the dog swimming up and down. Through here, this is the actual onsen. This is a hot spring, hot baths. And they actually look just like the ones that you have for people. How much does it cost to have your dog going in the hot springs and being shampooed and things?
Usually your owner spends more than 10,000.
So well over $100. How often does this dog come?
About once a week.
So $6,000 a year on dog swimming. So it's a very pampered dog, this dog.
Our customer dogs are like a member of family, so they are pretty much loved.
So like all the best hot springs for people, this place has got lotions and potions you can buy. Pretty expensive, mine. Wow. Small bottle of shampoo, that's $50. That's a dog nappy in different sizes for different kinds of dogs. And then over here there's Royal Jerry. I think it's Royal Jelly, actually. It's some kind of a dog food supplement. And that's about $60 there. And over here they've got some dog T-shirts. And the brand is Hot Dog. So these people are taking pictures of their Cavalier King Charles Spaniel that's wearing a dress, obviously, and in a buggy. And the buggy's got pink satiny flounces decorating it. Buggies and bags are essential for any self-respecting dog, like Jiro's miniature dachshund Kotaro.
My dog, he really hate to go out with his feet. So I have a nice bag, and he really love to go out within the bag.
So he doesn't like walking?
He doesn't like walking at all.
To be fair, dogs have to be in a bag or buggy to travel on trains in Tokyo, the most populous city in the world.
It's huge number of people living together. If we get on the train at rush hour, it's fully packed people. It's really hell.
Outside the Shibuya railway station is Tokyo's busiest intersection. A popular meeting place amongst the crowds is this small statue of Hachiko, a dog who waited here at the station for his late master every day from 1925 to 1935. It's hard to believe it among the crowds milling around Hachiko's statue, but Japan's population is shrinking fast. The latest government projection shows if current trends continue, today's 128 million will fall to 43 million over the next century, a staggering decrease of two-thirds. So, has any country experienced such a precipitous demographic decline before? A question I put to Ryuichi Kaneko, Deputy Director of the National Institute of Population and Social Security Research.
I don't think so. Of course, many developed countries is now experiencing declining rate of population increase. But we may be the first to have a severe population decline.
And what are the implications for an advanced industrialized economy like this of that kind of precipitous fall in population?
First of all, the workforce will be shrinking. Younger people have to support the elderly. So the burden of younger people very rapidly becomes heavier than they endure.
Successive Japanese governments have tried to introduce maternity leave, increase child benefits, and provide nursery places to no avail.
Apparently, it is not enough to affect Japanese fertility. The problem is much more complicated than first sight.
We've been looking as well at the population of pets, and there's many more pets than children. Do you think the two are connected? The lower birth rate and more people having pets?
I don't have a scientific answer, but I feel it is connected.
Although more women have jobs in Japan these days, private companies are reluctant to make allowances for mothers. 60% of women leave work after having their first child. The women of Japan, like eye surgeon Toshiko Horikoshi, have responded with what amounts to a baby strike.
My boss actually told me, if we want to become a good doctor, you just avoid having a child, or you will ruin your career. That's the reason I don't have a child.
Dr. Horikoshi was once pregnant, but lost her baby.
When I got married, my ex-husband wanted to have a baby. He wanted me to be a housewife, but I really wanted to work as a resident doctor. I needed to study and work hard. So he hit me because he wanted me to be back home early. He hit me. I lost my baby. So I decided to divorce. And after that, I found a good life with working as a doctor and dog.
It's a sunny Sunday, and the pet lovers of Tokyo have gathered in this park for what's called a wanwan carnival, a doggy carnival. And there are lots of dogs, about a dozen or so, up on a stage. This is actually an obedience training competition. But to be honest, it looks more like a fancy dress competition. There's a black pug dressed up as a baby. It looks like it's wearing a nappy. And then there's a French bulldog that's over there as well. Now, it's got a kind of harness on with bread buns on either side of it and a big squirt of yellow mustard on its back, obviously dressed as a hot dog. Chia, when you see this celebration of everything doggy, what do you think?
I feel something sad about it.
Sad? Why?
When I think about the reason why people are this obsessed with dogs, they're trying to make up some of their issue, loneliness or some loss or something with dogs. Maybe that's my feeling.
Even at the end, the life of a dog can be commemorated with reverence. There are even temples where dead dogs are laid to rest with full Buddhist rites. A deluxe funeral and cremation ceremony can cost upwards of $8,000.
We will put the body of the dog in front there, and I will sing the sutra. I find these days the families of the pets, their grief is even stronger than the families who lost their parents or grandparents. I think it is because pets are just like their child. So it is like a losing child. And maybe losing their parents is maybe a bit easier to accept, but losing a child is very difficult.
So more grief for the dog than parents. I mean, that's amazing, don't you think?
I was just surprised to hear a story by a temple member that when they lost their parents, they cried all day. But when they lost their pets, they cried for a whole week. It is very obvious when we visit members' house, there are fewer children around.
Are you worried about that?
もちろんそうです。 Of course, I'm worried. As a human being, we have to evolve and pass our tradition to the next generation.
Japan's population fell by a record number last year. And in the wake of the earthquake and nuclear disasters, the National Institute of Population Research is expecting there to be a further decline in births this year, says Ryuichi Kanako.
We realized that we are living in a much more dangerous world. So some young people hesitate to have children.
And Jiro shares that hesitation.
I think most of Japanese people worry about the future because we believe we have a more big earthquake in the quite near future, definitely. And then I think most Japanese people start to think their life more seriously.
So what are the long-term implications of these trends when the government is already struggling to boost growth and rein in soaring welfare costs in the world's most rapidly aging society? Ryu Ichi Kaneko believes there'll be no easy remedy for Japan's low fertility rate.
Government and all people in Japan are very aware of the problem. But it is very difficult to provide the governmental financial aid for children. Companies are also aware of the problem. But the economic situation is very severe. So it is kind of a dilemma.
I know, you know, the government, they try to change the system for the young couple. But even government makes lots of, you know, the nursery home or tax reduce. I don't think it's good enough to decide to having baby for us.
We all, the company, government, young people and elderly, all have to think about this problem very seriously. Otherwise, Japan itself will be in a very hard time.
Do you think it's that serious, that Japan itself could be, you know, threatened in that way?
Yes.
Others, of course, don't share Ryuichi Kaneko's pessimism. Perhaps fewer people would be no bad thing. These islands are already so crowded. There may be the option of more immigration. There's not been much so far. One thing is certain, everything Japan has tried so far has failed to arrest its demographic decline. Fresh thinking will be needed to persuade more Japanese that in the long term, man's best friend can be no substitute for man himself.
Bye-bye, Kotaro.
As Jiro says goodbye to Kotaro to go to work, he reflects on his own future without children.
We know not having baby, it's a really bad thing for us. We cannot have a pension without any young people. When I get on the train, I saw the many, many pensioners enjoying their retirement. They sometimes go to the nice restaurant to have nice dinner or nice lunch, whatever, because they have enough pension and they have enough family. They don't have to worry about their future or lack of money. I cannot see my bright future like this for my old age.
It's A Dog's Life was presented by Roland Burke. It was a Ruth Evans production for the BBC World Service. BBC.